Aptera Motors could harness UNSW's breakthrough in nighttime solar power generation. In the world of electric vehicles, EVs, innovation is a constant driving force. One of the companies at the forefront of this revolution is Aptera Motors, a forward-thinking manufacturer of solar-powered electric vehicles. Aptera's mission is to create hyper-efficient, sustainable vehicles, and they have already made headlines with their ultra-aerodynamic solar-powered EVs. However, for Aptera's mission to succeed on a global scale, including in regions with low sunlight or periods of low light intensity, advancements in solar technology are crucial. Recent breakthroughs from the University of New South Wales, UNSW, present a new frontier in renewable energy, the ability to generate solar power even after the sun has set. This technology, based on thermoradiative power generation, holds the potential to significantly benefit Aptera's solar-powered vehicles, especially in low-light regions. While Aptera Motors has made significant strides in developing solar-powered electric vehicles, the current limitations of traditional solar panels restrict their ability to generate power during periods of low sunlight, particularly in high-latitude regions or during the winter months. As the global demand for energy-efficient off-grid vehicles grows, how can Aptera leverage recent advancements in thermoradiative power generation technology, such as UNSW's breakthrough device that captures infrared emissions at night to enhance vehicle performance in low-light environments and reduce reliance on external power sources? Let's delve in. For the amazing work that goes in here, kindly return the favor by giving this video a like, subscribe, and leave your thoughts in the comments section below. Aptera Motors vehicles are designed to use integrated solar panels to capture sunlight and convert it into electricity. Their vision of a car that runs solely on solar energy is becoming increasingly feasible as solar technology advances. However, the challenge has always been ensuring consistent power generation, especially in regions where sunlight is not abundant or during nighttime. Aptera's current technology is impressive, capable of generating up to 40 miles of range per day through its solar panels in ideal conditions. But in areas with limited sunlight, such as high-latitude countries or during winter months, additional solutions are needed to keep the vehicle running efficiently. This is where UNSW's recent breakthrough in solar technology could be a game-changer. The development of a device capable of generating electricity after sunset by harnessing the Earth's infrared emissions opens up new possibilities for extending the range and functionality of solar-powered vehicles, especially in low-light environments. What is more about the breakthrough in nighttime solar power at UNSW? Let's start by looking at how the technology works. The core of UNSW's solar breakthrough lies in thermoradiative power generation. The device utilizes a thermoradiative diode, a specialized semiconductor, to generate electricity by capturing infrared radiation emitted by the Earth as it cools down at night. This contrasts with traditional solar cells, which generate electricity by absorbing visible light from the sun. Thermoradiative diodes function similarly, but in reverse, emitting infrared light into the cooler environment of space and converting this process into usable electric current. The principle behind this process is not new. It relies on temperature differentials, a concept widely understood in physics and engineering, but applying it to generate electricity on a significant scale is a novel achievement. Although the power output of this device is currently modest, roughly 100,000 times less than that of conventional solar panels, the concept has far-reaching implications for solar energy's future. Over time, continued development and optimization of the technology could lead to much higher efficiencies, transforming it into a viable power source for various applications. For Aptera Motors, this technology offers a solution to one of the biggest challenges for solar-powered vehicles operating efficiently in regions with low light intensity. Countries located at higher latitudes, such as those in Scandinavia or Canada, often experience limited daylight hours during certain seasons. In such regions, Aptera vehicles might struggle to generate sufficient energy from sunlight alone. Thermoradiative power generation could provide an auxiliary energy source during the night, allowing the vehicle to continue charging even when sunlight is unavailable. This technology can effectively increase the vehicle's range in low-light conditions, ensuring that Aptera owners in less sunny climates can enjoy the same level of performance and convenience as those in sunnier regions. How can integrating thermoradiative technology improve Aptera's design and energy efficiency, especially in low-sunlight regions, to create a more sustainable self-powered vehicle? Aptera Motors is all about efficiency. Their vehicles are designed to minimize energy consumption through advanced aerodynamics, lightweight materials, and optimized energy storage systems. By integrating UNSW's nighttime solar technology in regions with limited sunlight, the thermoradiative diode could serve as a supplemental energy source, contributing to the vehicle's overall power needs while minimizing their reliance on external charging stations or grid electricity. This synergy between thermoradiative technology and Aptera's design ethos could redefine what it means to be an energy-efficient vehicle. Not only would Aptera's vehicles be capable of running on renewable energy during the day, but they could also generate power during the night, creating a 24-hour renewable energy cycle. This would be a significant step forward in reducing the overall environmental footprint of electric vehicles, making them more sustainable and practical in diverse environmental conditions. Furthermore, by reducing dependency on external charging infrastructure, one of the main selling points of Aptera vehicles is their ability to operate off-grid thanks to their solar panels. However, in low-light conditions, owners may still need to rely on external charging infrastructure to power their vehicles. By incorporating thermoradiative technology, Aptera could further reduce this dependency, allowing the vehicle to generate its own power around the clock. This would be particularly beneficial for rural or remote areas where access to charging stations is limited. Aptera's long-term vision is to create a vehicle that can operate indefinitely without needing to plug into the grid, and nighttime solar power generation could bring this vision closer to reality. Potential applications of UNSW thermoradiative nighttime solar power technology beyond automotive includes 1. Wearable technology. UNSW's breakthrough is not just limited to vehicles. One of the potential applications of thermoradiative technology is in wearable devices. In the same way that Aptera could use the technology to charge vehicles at night, wearable electronics could also harness body heat or ambient infrared radiation to power themselves. This could lead to a new generation of self-sustaining fitness trackers, smartwatches, and medical devices that never need recharging. 2. Space exploration. Perhaps the most exciting application of this technology is in space. Satellites and spacecraft often operate in environments where sunlight is scarce or unavailable for extended periods. Currently, they rely on batteries to store power for these dark phases. Thermoradiative diodes could allow them to generate power continuously, even when they are in the shadow of a planet or during the long nights experienced on the Moon or Mars. This could revolutionize space technology by extending mission durations, reducing payload weights, and cutting costs associated with battery storage. Although the potential for thermoradiative power generation is immense, the technology is still in its infancy. The current efficiency levels are quite low, and the amount of electricity generated is far below what traditional solar panels produce. For Aptera to integrate this technology into their vehicles, significant improvements will be necessary to make it practical for large-scale use. Researchers are optimistic, however, that with continued development, the technology will improve. Over the next 5 to 10 years, we can expect advancements in thermoradiative diode efficiency and overall power output. As this technology matures, Aptera Motors could be among the first automotive companies to adopt it, positioning themselves as pioneers in nighttime solar vehicle technology. For future Aptera owners living in areas with limited sunlight, integration of nighttime solar power could make owning and operating a solar vehicle more convenient and accessible than ever before. Without much ado, the breakthrough of the University of New South Wales in thermoradiative power generation offers exciting possibilities for the future of solar technology, including future Aptera owners. While the technology is still in development, its potential to extend the range of solar-powered vehicles and reduce dependency on external charging infrastructure is undeniable. And there you have it for now. It's been fantastic having you with us this far. If you've enjoyed the incredible work that goes into these videos, please show your support by giving this video a thumbs up and share your thoughts in the comments below. Also, be sure to subscribe to this channel and turn on the bell notification icon to stay up to speed with new publications. Your engagement means a lot. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.